your boy you. He got that Mika love. I mean, honestly, that the most flamboyant damn scene ever, but cute at the same time. He actually got Mika back on his side, and he actually gave Mika some of his blood. But the way he took his blood, it was just as if they were just having some type of makeout moment, and how he held them like, yes, bro, suck it. Suck it all. I was just staring at shit like, that would make that vampire shit look gay. I don't know why. This is always make it look gay. And no, I don't have nothing. I don't have no problem with gay people at all. I'm just making a statement. But they really didn't make that gay though. But I like how you kind of convinced Mika that he had to protect. You know, he got to protect his other family. And Mika's like, okay, I saved them for kids that actually look out for me. Everybody else, fuck them bitches. They get a experience on you, and I know they did, but, you know, they still his family, got to protect them. And not to mention the experience, I wonder what that little girl that they got tied up with that damn thing could actually do. Because she looks like she's going to be a force to be reckoned with. Now, Mika is also a full-breed vampire right now. He got red eyes. He can't never go back to being himself again. He turned to a monster, but that was the only way to sustain his life, because he was about to die. You had to do what he had to do in order to save his family. Hopefully, you will be his regular suck my blood source type of guy. So we gonna see that in a yet another anime. I think that happened in one other anime I was looking at when his best friend or the sister just gave him the blood and he ain't take blood for nobody else. Or was it a girl? It was some fucking anime that I was watching. I can't even think of it. But yeah, this getting real good. I can't wait to see exactly how this war is going to end. But could they be Chloe? Who knows? But anyway, tell you guys, stay. Make sure you rate, comment, and subscribe. I'm out of here. Peace.